If you are going swimming with sunscreen this summer, there are a few things you need to know in order to stay safe and protected, because sunscreen doesn't always work as well as manufacturers want you to think it does. And today I want to break down what you actually need to know and what you should look for when it comes to wearing your sunscreen. So the first thing is that when you're swimming and when you're in the water, you might notice that you see this kind of film. If you're wearing sunscreen, you notice how it kind of makes like this holographic pattern on the water. That's actually the sunscreen coming off of you. And obviously, if it comes off of you and into the water, it's not going to be protecting you as well as it should. Now, a beautiful butterfly actually commented this, but she said that she learned the hard way that water resistant is not the same as waterproof. And that's very true. If you have a sunscreen and if it says water resistant for up to 80 minutes, that doesn't mean that your sunscreen is going to protect you for 80 minutes. That doesn't even mean that you can be in the water for 80 minutes and be safe. It just means that it's water resistant. Water resistant kind of gets into definitions, and this is where some cosmetic companies can be a little bit tricky with the way they word things and try to sell you things. Yeah, so I talk a lot with my hands, don't I? Very Italian. Parle italiano. Water resistant. My iPhone is water resistant, right? So if I splash you, technically, that should be okay. But if I fully submerge my phone in the water, it's probably not going to work that well, right? Same with sunscreen. If someone splashes me, I'm probably going to be okay. But if I fully submerge, and especially if I rub my skin, that sunscreen isn't going to stay where it needs to be. And it means that I'm at a risk of burning. Also, usually people are in the water when it's warm outside. It's usually warm when the sun is hot. And also, the sun actually gets magnified by the water itself. The water can kind of act as like a little bit of a magnifying glass. If you ever put water on a still surface, whether it's a plate or ground or whatever it is you choose, you notice how it kind of makes a dome. That dome shape can actually magnify and intensify rays, meaning that while you're swimming, you're probably not feeling the heat of the sun, and you're also literally inside of the water, and this can start to penetrate and to do damage to your skin. And especially if you're using a sunscreen that's coming off in the water, you're not as protected as you think. And that's how some people can get these really bad burns that they weren't expecting even with the use of sunscreen. People also don't realize how often you have to reapply sunscreen. Just because this is SPF 28, it doesn't mean that I'm 28 protected from the sun, 28%. Sunscreens that are 30% usually have a protection rate of, I think, 94 to 96%, and like an SPF 99 has like, I think, a 99% rate of protection from penetration. But what these numbers refer to is how long you have until you have to reapply. Most people don't know you have to reapply your sunscreen every 2 to 4 hours. And if you're wearing makeup, that's hella freaking frustrating. And even at the beach or at the pool, if you're swimming, if you're scuba diving for an hour and a half, that's really difficult to reapply. And that's where things like wetsuits or hats or t-shirts or sitting in the shade come in, because that is going to be a lot more effective than just sunscreens. And I also want to remind you that there are physical and mineral sunscreens, as well as chemical sunscreens. I personally like physical and mineral. They're better for the oceans, they're better for my body, and they do not absorb into the bloodstream. Chemical sunscreens have been used for a long time. They're better than using no sunscreen. But recently, JAMA, a medical journal, kind of showed that avobenzone and oxybenzone seem to enter the bloodstream at a higher level than what was regarded as safe and what was approved initially. So we have videos on that. I think it's important for you to educate yourself so that you can make the right choice for you. But personally, I like physical and mineral. Remember, this 28 only reflects how long I have until I have to reapply. And if you go into the sun and you burn in 5 minutes, this means that it's only going to protect you like SPF 30 for a specific amount of time. Now, if somebody else goes into the sun and they can be in the sun for 30 minutes and they don't burn, their same exact sunscreen is going to last a lot longer before they need to reapply. And that's where things like Fitzpatrick levels or phototypes or different skin types come into play. Even people who do have different skin tones can have varying degrees of skin sensitivity and sun sensitivity, but that doesn't mean that everyone is protected. Melanoma is a very dangerous type of skin cancer, and unfortunately it can happen to people all across that spectrum. So when it comes to staying safe, and if you are going to be swimming this summer, remember to look for a sunscreen that is not only water resistant, but that does seem to have ingredients that are going to repel water better. Again, this doesn't even have to do with the active ingredients, but it has to do with everything else on that list. And remember that if you're in the water, this is magnifying. You see how you can kind of see the bottom of the pool or those pretty light patterns on the bottom of the ocean? that's how the light reflects and refracts within the water. And unfortunately, that can do damage to us. So be aware, cover up when you can, and I hope that this video helps to clear up some things that my 19-minute videos definitely get into, but it takes like 17 minutes before we hit that point that it's explained. So if you want to see more sunscreen videos, I have a whole playlist here. Here's a little bit more info on coconut oil, since this one contains a coconut ingredient and whether or not coconut will break you out. Hope that you beautiful butterflies are having a beautiful day, and I cannot wait to see you in the next video. Love you guys. Bye.